In this video, we are going to talk about the biodegradation of hydrocarbons, the mechanistic perspective. Coming to the definition of hydrocarbons, according to the classical definition of hydrocarbons, these are any class of organic chemicals made up of only the elements carbon and hydrogen. The carbon atoms joined together to form the framework of the compound, and the hydrogen atoms attached to them in many different configurations. Depending on the structure of hydrocarbons, they can be differentiated into two categories, aliphatic and alicyclic. Aliphatic hydrocarbons can be further divided into saturated and unsaturated category, while the alicyclic hydrocarbons can be homocyclic or heterocyclic. Homocyclic hydrocarbons can be further differentiated into aromatic, non-aromatic and anti-aromatic hydrocarbons. What are the microorganisms involved in the biodegradation of hydrocarbons? There can be different classes of microbes that are involved in the process. Often, multiple microbial strains cooperatively degrade a single pollutant. Microorganisms have different enzymatic machineries to use hydrocarbons as a source of energy. These are found residing in the hydrocarbon-contaminated waste sites. Examples of bacteria that participate in hydrocarbon degradation can be Pseudomonas putida, Pseudomonas fluorescens, Planococcus species, etc. Different species under actinomycetes category like Nocardia, Mycobacterium, Streptomyces, etc. can be involved in this process. Fungal strains that are capable of degrading hydrocarbons, examples are Methylocinus, Trichosporium and Aspergillus, etc. What are the sites of hydrocarbon contaminations in the environment? Different contaminated land areas from different industries, waste sites can be a site of hydrocarbon contaminations. Oil spillages from oil mines in the marine sea vents can be sites of hydrocarbon contaminations. Other hydrocarbon contamination sites may include agricultural runoff fields from pesticide contaminations, automobile oil spills, and urban stormwater discharges. What are the adverse effects of hydrocarbon pollution on the environment? Hydrocarbon pollution can be a matter of huge concern due to its adversities imposed on the surroundings. Aldehydes and alkyl nitrate-like substances can chemically react again to produce nitrous oxide, which can affect blood vessels, liver, kidneys, and the nervous system. Other components like methane, chlorofluorocarbons, these can drastically alter the atmosphere and contribute enormously to global warming. Aromatic hydrocarbons can deplete red blood cells, cause cancer in mammals, and damage bone marrow. Massive oil spills may inhibit respiratory function in animals and humans, thus causing severe distress to aquatic flora and fauna. What are the factors that determine the biodegradability of hydrocarbons? The susceptibility to degradation of these hydrocarbons depends on the chain length of hydrocarbons type and size of the component. In alkanes of chain length of 10 carbons and 24 carbons are degraded rapidly. Longer the chain, lesser is the tendency to be degraded. Short length alkanes are very toxic in nature. Long chain alkanes are resistant to biodegradation and are thus recalcitrant in nature. Presence of branched chain structures increase resistance to biodegradation due to interference by tertiary and quaternary carbon atoms. The presence of benzene ring, that is aromatic and polyaromatic hydrocarbons, are more recalcitrant as compared to the aliphatic ones. Now coming to the biodegradation of different types of hydrocarbons. Alkenes, for example, methane, ethane, and propane can be degraded aerobically or anaerobically. Degradation of alicyclic hydrocarbons like cyclopropane, cyclobutane, cyclohexane, cyclohexene, etc. can be via the formation of fatty acids by a series of reactions that finally degrades via beta oxidation pathway. aromatic hydrocarbons, for example, benzene, naphthalene, benzopyrene, benzaldehyde, anisole, vanillin, etc., can be degraded by the orthocleavage pathway or the metacleavage pathway. Coming to the degradation of alkenes, they can be aerobically or anaerobically biodegraded. Aerobic biodegradation may involve enzymes that have obligatory requirement for molecular oxygen. The main enzymes that are involved in this process are monooxygenases and dioxygenases. Monooxygenases initially attack on the alkane with an insertion of one molecule of oxygen, finally converting it into the primary alcohol. Here, NADPH acts as the electron donor. While in case of dioxygenases, initial attack on alkane takes place with insertion of one molecule of oxygen that converts it into a labile hydroperoxide intermediate, which is further converted into alcohol, aldehyde, and finally fatty acid. This fatty acid is subject to beta oxidation, leading to formation of acetyl-CoA. Acetyl-CoA is converted to carbon dioxide and water via TCA cycle, thus complete mineralization of the pollutant occurs. Now coming to the anaerobic biodegradation, where in this process the presence of molecular oxygen is not required. Formation of an alkene is the first step as a result of dehydrogenation reaction. This is followed by the formation of alcohol, aldehyde, and fatty acid. Rest of the reaction follows similarly as in case of aerobic mechanism. Degradation of alicyclic hydrocarbons. Here we have used cyclohexane as an example. Hydroxylation reaction mediated by enzyme like monooxygenase helps in the conversion of cyclohexane into an alicyclic alcohol. Here it is cyclohexanol. Dehydrogenation of this alicyclic alcohol leads to the formation of a ketone, C-caprolactone, which is further oxygenated into 6-hydroxyhexanoic acid. A stepwise dehydrogenation leads to the formation of 6-oxohexanoic acid and finally the fatty acid, that is adipic acid, which is now subject to beta oxidation. Finally, coming to the degradation of aromatic hydrocarbons, that may involve two major pathways. The first pathway is the orthocleavage pathway, where benzene gets oxygenated into catechol, which is further oxygenated to form 2-hydroxycis-cis muconic semialdehyde. Further hydroxylation reactions lead to the formation of 2-keto-4-pentenoic acid, finally, which is converted into acetaldehyde and pyruvic acid that can enter the TCA cycle. The second pathway is metacleavage pathway, which involves the formation of cis-cis muconic acid from catechol, which is further oxygenated into beta-ketoadipic acid, along with the addition of acetyl-CoA in the next step. It is converted into one molecule of succinic acid, along with one molecule of acetyl-CoA. Finally, the acetyl-CoA joins the TCA cycle, which is again converted into carbon dioxide and water. Thus, complete mineralization of hydrocarbon takes place without the generation of any toxic byproducts. So, hereby, we can conclude that the hydrocarbons that contaminates the environment from different oil spills and other contaminated sites like benzene, naphthalene, cyclopropane, cyclobutane, methane, ethane, etc. can be completely mineralized into carbon dioxide and water with the help of the process bioremediation. Hence, we can conclude that microorganisms are the only hope to a contamination-free, clean, sustainable, green future. So that's all about hydrocarbon biodegradation by the help of microbes. We will come with more informative videos. Keep your eyes on biospecifics for further updates. Thank you.